join me. Together, we can rule the galaxy far from sound.
I am a Jedi, like my father before me.
This is getting out of hand. Now there are two of them.
Bonus episode, here we go. All right, it is day 13. We are less than 2 weeks away from the Book of Boba Fett, but we are going to be taking a look at The Sanctuary, episode 4, or chapter 4, from The Mandalorian, season 1. This one, Sanctuary, is a super interesting one. This is a classic Western kind of trope as well. Farm village, getting hit by marauders, and the lone gunsman comes in and helps saves the town, but and essentially helps them protect themselves in their village, you know. So this is written by Jon Favreau, directed by Bryce Dallas Howard, and they go to the planet of Sorgan after the intense battle at I'm blanking on the planet name, but anyways, they get out of here. He's trying to stay low. The Mandalorian's trying to stay low. So they go to this place called Sorgan, which is a forest-ish, swampy-ish kind of planet. Again, understand that, many planets have different weather things, but in Star Wars land, it is usually one or two or a mix of both, and this is a mix. It's a forest swamp planet. That's what it is. And so the Raiders, not the Tusken Raiders, but I think these are Clatoonians. We see them on one of Jabba's henchmen in Return of Jedi. But we have that. It sets up. We have a peaceful village. And dude, I love the little, it's only in a couple scenes, but I love the droid, the fishing droid. It's got like stork legs and an astromech body, and it picks up krill, and it's fantastic. I just love that one. I don't know why. I love the design of the village. It's also very Star Wars, with the rounded grassy rooftops. It's very Ralph McQuarrie-ish. And it's got this cool, like, little grid with the little pools of this krill. And, oh, man, it's so good. It's so good. That, if you don't appreciate that, then we got our first live-action Loth Cat. Oh, man, love that. The hisses at Baby Yoda. There's a great part at the beginning of this episode where, he's talking to him like a child. And he's like, hey, man, you stay here. I'm going to get us some lodging, and he opens up the door, and there is Baby Yoda. Oh my gosh, I just love it. The humor is good with Baby Yoda. Of course, we get the infamous meme of him drinking his bone soup as the introduction of Cara Dune's character, I flipped that around, or Gina Carano's character, Cara Dune, and she is a formal rebel shock trooper, and they have a little tussle. Again, Mando uses flamethrower weird. Like, I don't know why he would flame it first before he not flame it in her face or whatever. I'm not really sure what that was, but anyways, they have a little wrestle, little tussle, and they point guns at each other, and there is our Baby Yoda just drinking some soup, watching them, some bone broth. Ah, just love it. It's so funny. So cool. They have this tussle, and Mando's like, all right, I got to get out of here because one's too many. One's crowded in this whole planet. I guess Mando's like, planet's already taken. Clearly, one person is dominating the planet. I'm not sure what that means. But he goes, trying to just do stuff on the ship, and then the farmers come like, hey, we need help, and He doesn't want to do it, but then he changes his mind, gets credits, and Cara Dune and himself, a Mandalorian, are going to train the villagers. They devise this plan. They go entice the camp. Well, no, they do a little. Look, I jump around. I apologize. They do a little recon. Oops, chicken walker, not good. They're like, nah, we're not doing it. But then, change of heart, and they're gonna train everybody. We have this cool montage of a training thing and all this stuff. The one cool thing, Omera, which is the widow mother, when they're doing the training, she's got this gun, and it's totally Bosk's gun. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it's called, but it's like a. I should know my Star Wars blasters, but yeah, if you play Battlefront, you know what I'm talking about. That is totally Bosk's gun, which is cool. So they use a couple older props, and yeah, so they go to the camp at night and blow up the little tent and get the Klaatunians to come and fight and tussle. Now, here's a little Jurassic Park nod. Eyes are red in the Chicken Walker, which makes it look like kind of like a dinosaur or evil machine, a mechanical machine. It's very cool. And so it attacks, it comes out of woods like a dinosaur, and there's just this really cool shot of it's like a long shot with the Chicken Walker on one side and the village on the other, with like the light coming from the moonlight, and it's just so good. But then the Chicken Walker is wise to their plan and doesn't want to step in, but there's Cara Dune just like taking pot shots, and finally he takes the bait and he falls in a pool, and then Mando comes in and throws a sticky grenade in there, boom boom boom. And yay, the village is saved, and then the Klaatunians come and they're tussling, and then the two farm hands that went to solicit Mando for his services, they actually take the leader down with their sticks, and it's pretty cool. And yeah, it's just a great fun episode. It's cool. It's a little, it's got these really cool kind of peaceful moments, and then these really tender moments with the she's kind of asking Mando about the code, and you can retire, and he's like, I've never taken this mask off. And then Cara Dune even says, like, what? So you could just take off the mask? Yeah, but then I can't put it back on. And she's like, okay, no big deal. But then things get real, real. There is a he kind of looks like a Cubez again. It's some kind of bounty hunter. And he has a tracking fob. And we see him through the scope. We see the Mandalorian. Then he scopes out Baby Yoda, and then it looks like he pulls the trigger. There's birds, and everybody's like, "Get down, get down!" But it's Cara Dune to the rescue. She gets on the jump, and now he's like, "We gotta get out of here." So they part ways, and yeah, and there you have it. That's it. That's a wrap for the Sanctuary. It's a cool vibe. It's got a cool vibe to it. I love what Bryce Dallas Howard brings to the table. Little Star Wars and graffiti, American graffiti with Ron Howard and all that kind of stuff. So the Howard family is in tight with the Lucas family. It's just cool to see her play in this space. Yeah, I just adore this one. This is a cool, it's got real good heart, and that is what Star Wars is all about. Building this relationship, and there's a couple cool action scenes as well. And hey, like I said, we got a Loth Cat, we got Yoda drinking bone soup, and yeah, it's just fun. Just fun. So there you have it. That is Until next time, we'll talk to you soon. Then we're only on day 12. Yay! Talk to you soon. Bye.